We are at REI 2018. I am Mohit. Hi, we are at REI 2018 and we are at JA Solar Stall. Today we have Mr. Stephen with us. Thank you, Stephen, for your time.
Thank you very much.
Please tell us about the products or the portfolio that company has for the Indian market.
For us, we actually, JA Solar has every product. But I think, you know, for India, it's more of a mass market and it's more price sensitive, to be very honest. So here we promote like two products. One is the standard poly, one is Perk Mono. Perk Mono is a new product which is very cost efficient, so which is already got a lot of traction in India. I think they will grow very fast.
Okay. What type of market do you see for the JA Solar in the next coming years?
You mean in India?
In India.
In India, I think the market these 2 years will be a bit, let's say, shaky because of this uncertainty of the policy. You know that safeguard duty, you know anti-dumping, and the elections, all this, and then developers now, they are a bit skeptical. They don't know what to do to bid for the projects. So you can see even the frequency of the bidding is coming less and less. And even this the tenure for this PPA will be like starting from 12 months and then extended to 24 months, meaning that whatever bidding today, it will be finished in 2020. So next year, this year already low, not very, you know, grow very fast. Next year, because of that, people believe might not be a lot of growing market in India, but still it will be good market, but not, you know, very big market.
What type of impact do you see of imposition of safeguard duty, particularly when it's come to the players like you?
I think safeguard duty would impact more on local player, I mean developers. You might see them struggling, you know, when they want to buy the product from China. And actually, the product from China, those are the big brands, the top brand, which the investors and lenders, they want, not local players. So if the cost is not justified, it will be very difficult for them to finish this project. And we definitely will help them, so we reduce the cost and we try to match and then let them know that we'll help them to finish all these projects. And for that, I think, you know, we will still get the project work. I think the problem for the developer is for the coming projects, what they want to do for that, if they will bid for the higher PPA, meaning that because the cost will be higher, they need to consider that, and that would turn out increase the cost of the energy. Then the impact back to India itself, not to us. Yes.
What kind of revenue does the company puts in for the R&D to develop the products?
For us, since JA is, previously we only did cell. Okay, so cell is this. This is a module and cell is inside. We only did cell. So we actually, that's the one we generate the power. So we are the leading company. We have a lot of R&D expenses on that. And we have like R&D lab in all our factories. We have 4 or 5 factories and we have 4 or 5 labs there. So those, why we can lead the market, we can get the better efficiency, we can get better products, we can pass all the certificate, even BIS, TUV, all the certificate we passed, then we can, you know, provide these products. That's also our strength. And if we compare to like smaller player, they don't have these R&D expenses, they can only follow. And for that, that would be our advantage.
What type of policy does he want from the government so that the companies like JA Solar can prosper better in the Indian market?
I think policy-wise, as long as it is encouraged the market, not necessary to the supplier or, you know, like a local manufacturer or for, I don't know, developers, as long as it is consistent, as long as it is encouraging to the market, it will be good for us because then we know how to react, how we comply with, even we can like produce in India as well, but I mean that has to be very consistent, and we have the faith, we have the confidence to do it.
And finally, do you plan to establish any manufacturing unit in India?
Actually, we evaluated that, and for now, it will be slightly difficult because we don't know where the policy will go, to be very honest. And the uncertainty everybody knows here, you know, you are in India, right? So for now, the policy is a bit shaky. Even safeguard duty, you know, it was discussed a very long time, and it suddenly came out even before the core decision comes out. So no one can predict what the government will do, and we don't have the sufficient information to evaluate the risk, which we cannot control. Then this investment will be very difficult for us.
Thank you, Stephen. Thank you so much.